backyard barbecue. Let me show you some of the items that I have available to me out here. Let's see if I can get up close on this, show y'all this. I got some wooden fire starter. Hope y'all can see that. Some wooden fire starter from a place called Lulu's, kind of like a super Walmart, if you want to call it. They look like this. They fire starters, cube fire starters, right? Don't have my chimney over here. So, I use what I got. Got my handy lighter. Excuse me. Got some cherry chips. Remember I was talking about my lump coal and stuff? Got lump coal in here. I don't know if y'all can see that. I don't really want to dump it out. This is my plastic bag, y'all. I walked out of the restaurant with. So I'm going to use some of that today. I'm going to show you the charcoal or the lump coal I'm using, right? This is some Cowboy brand. I'm not saying it's the best, but I use what I got. It works. I don't believe I can get 24 hours out of this, but I don't need it for 24 hours over here. Hardwood lump. And, yeah, the Cowboy brand of the briquettes. They're lump briquettes, if they want to call it that. So, you don't use, in these, they don't recommend you use the charcoal cube, but these are lump briquettes. So, I'm gonna use them for what we do. So, I'm gonna get started, y'all. I gotta clean my grill out. Y'all see it's dusty over here. Give y'all a view real quick, man. Y'all see what I'm working with out here, man. I'm gonna give y'all that panoramic view. Hey, y'all see little Titan out there, huh? Yeah. Y'all see some water out there. These little towers, stuff like that. Let me walk on the other side, man. See where I'm at. In this convoluted city, they steady building up. Like that empty space, next time y'all see me on the video, it might be a tower there. They building up out here. Anyway, I'm in the middle of no man's land. Just making it do what it do. I had them put my grill on top of it. You see AC units over there. See my grill over here. All by itself. Got some little satellite dishes. This is where I'm at, y'all. Making it happen where I'm at, right? A barbecue, I only ship one thing over here, my grill. Like clothes and grill. Sorry about that. My clothes and grill. So anyway, like I said, we'll get started. We'll come back. I'm gonna go ahead and put the chicken on. And then let you see it in different parts. And then we're gonna close the video out, y'all. I hope y'all enjoy. Stay cool wherever you at. You see I'm already sweating. It's like 9 o'clock right now. So stay cool, like I said. Enjoy the AC, because that's where I'm about to go. As soon as I light this grill, y'all. See y'all in a little bit. What's good, y'all? We back, man. It's been 24 hours, man. I'm excited, man, to fire my grill and cook this quantity of meat, right? Just to see how long it's gonna take. You know, what's crazy is if I had Big Bertha, I could just load this thing out. This is nothing, but I'm using my egg today. So we'll see. It's gonna be a lot of going back and forth. Not so much to check it, but you know, put it on, set it up, forget it. Got it, but I gotta make sure that I pull it off at the right time. So it's gonna be tricky, right? With the heat elements out here and stuff like that. But we're gonna get it done. It's about 9 now. 9 in the morning where I'm at. And it's gotta be done by 6. So I'm about to get on my grind, fire this grill for about 45 minutes to an hour. Close the lid about 15 minutes, tweak it to where I want it, about 225-ish, 225, 250. And let the smoke roll, y'all. Anyway. I want you to see my chicken. Let me give you a close up real quick. Right? Y'all see the two different colors of meat, right? I know we talked about this particular one with the mixture of Montreal seasoning and the chef seasoning. But this one over here, I decided to, you know, just cause I'm trying to get my name out there, y'all. So I decided to go and put my famous jerk seasoning on that. Straight from Jamaica. But yeah, nah. So I'm gonna give them two different blends, man, to try to wow them over and win they services. Yeah, all right, let me go back, because I want to talk about something real quick, right? All right, so let me get a bottle of mustard, because something a comment, one of the comments from a fellow brother barbecue was out there at YouTube land.
Here is something that I want to talk about. Right? Somebody mentioned it in one of the comments. Hey, by the way, I appreciate your comment. I don't remember your name. But he mentioned about putting hot sauce. See where my head at this early in the morning. Anyway, mustard on anything other than pork. Well, for those who've been in the game for a minute, been cooking, I'll be honest with you. If you've been watching Barbecue Wars, the Pit Boys, whoever, right, people that actually know what this does, then you would know that you use this on anything, right? Let's elaborate, right? So part of it is becoming smart on what you're actually putting on that. Not, oh man, I only put it on there because that's all I ever did. That tells me that you haven't really done research on it, because I'm always trying to perfect my craft, right? So through you guys, whether you know it or not, you actually teach me things which make me better, right? Because I don't know it all. But anyway, with this right here, this mustard, man, there's two ingredients that people put on meat, and there's a reason why, right? It has nothing to do with taste. This is one of them. I don't have olive oil, but olive oil is the second. You put these on meat for what reason? I'll give you a second. All right, they put this on meat, and it ain't about taste, right? You can see the little bright orange color on there, and I got mustard on both of these. What it does is, you put mustard on there and olive oil to hold the seasoning on the meat. Because you pour seasoning on there, by the time you get ready to put it on the meat, it's on there, but it's not gonna stay if you're not used to a grill and how to perfect keeping the seasoning on there while you're cooking it at various temperatures. So we use these as, I don't say a paste, but that's what it does. You know, it's like putting glue on something and then pouring seasoning on it. It sticks to it while it's cooking. So that's the reason why we put mustard on everything. You, trust me, you will not taste mustard whatsoever, right? I'm gonna give you a freebie. I talk about this a little bit in some of my earlier videos. Paprika is another one. We use paprika not for taste, right? A lot of people, let me get this right. There's smoked paprika out there, right? And there's some other variants of smoked paprika, but I'm talking about raw uncut paprika. You don't put it on meat for taste, right? Not in the barbecue world. We put paprika on there because it's gonna make your meat bright red, right? So I'll say it adds to the display of your meat when you get it off the grill, right? It's gonna be bright red. And people go, oh my goodness, he know what he's doing. Look at this perfected chicken. It looks like the videos you see out there, KFC chicken or whatever the case may be. You know how the videos be getting you on that, or the commercials. And then you get your burger and stuff like that. You're like, man, this don't look like that video. That's what paprika does, right? So I could have, in theory, sprinkled that over this to make it bright red. But I'm not going to do that. But it's food for thought. Anyway, like I said, I appreciate the comment from a man. Keep them coming, man. As y'all talk about stuff, I'll talk about it on here. When I get a chance or when I'm doing something that relates to it, we'll talk about it. But I want y'all to see this chicken. The grill is already going. I'm going to wait a few more minutes. I'm taking this out for about 15 minutes, so it try to come close to room temperature. And then we're going to go from there, y'all. So I see y'all out there on the grill. Keep the smoke rolling, y'all. All right, everybody. All right, everybody, we're back. It's been about an hour with the chicken being on. Let's get a sneak peek of it real quick. Yeah. Pretty doggone good over there. Anyway, we'll be back, man. I'm gonna take off a few of these, leave these on, start adding meat, and we're gonna continue to go. I'll come back once this is done, show you what this looks like, and then I'll add the chicken wings, and then we'll go from there. Like I said, we got a whole lot of meat to cook today, so we'll continue to update you as we go. All right. Hey, what's up, everybody? We back, man. Part the AC unit going. Let me get you a little close up real quick. I just put some chicken on.
Let me make sure you can see that. That's the wings. Y'all see this other chicken season up. It's going on afterwards. I'm going to take it back down so it stay refrigerated. Yeah, look at that chicken. Yeah, we're getting down. Thousands of miles away, y'all. We're getting down over here. Anyway, I got to close this because if you're looking, you ain't cooking, y'all. So stay tuned. I'm going to show you the final product when all of this done. Send you on your way, y'all.
Hey, everybody. We are done. I'm about to put aluminum foil on it, put it inside my little tote bag. Man, I am tired. This has been about, I think I started about 9 this morning. And it is now about 6 o'clock, man. Pumping this chicken out of my little bitty baby grill. But anyway, let me give you a close-up and then send you on your way. I want to eat it, keep it for myself. Right? See the jerk on the left? And then, obviously, the Montreal seasoning. The chicken seasoning with the Chef Marietto's or whatever his name is. With the funny mustache. But anyway, like I said, I hope you enjoyed. More to come. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Holla at your boy, y'all. More videos coming.